Ich habe schon eine lange Zeit die Idee gehabt, eine Vision.
For a long time, I nursed the idea of constructing a very special astronomical clock. In its scientific, technical and aesthetic approach, this clock would be unique. After all, we should also use it to promote innovative and original ideas of our own.
So etwas eigen produzieren, etwas eigenes herstellen.
For years we discussed, planned and defined the specifications of this clock. Today you have this masterpiece in front of you, designed, constructed and assembled by a superb team, dedicated heart and soul to the construction of this precision timepiece. Franz Türler, the fourth generation of a watchmaker dynasty, is a man who found a way to transform his ideas into reality. From his business headquarters in the center of Zurich, he set the wheels of his project in motion. New scientific ideas and the arts have always needed the support of people with political and financial influence. Count Karl Eugene of Württemberg helped Philipp Matthäus Hahn, a clergyman, astronomer and scientist, to construct this beautiful model of the nearer cosmos. Hahn was one of a group of 18th century priest mechanics in South Germany, Austria and Switzerland. Secular patrons made it possible for these men of the cloth to construct elaborate astronomical clocks, globes and planetariums. What were then the new and still disputed theories of Copernicus, Kepler and Newton were transformed here into an understandable mechanical work of art. The function of this world machine was not to measure or split time into regular intervals, but to reveal a profound meaning behind the celestial movements. Ludovico Oechslin was the moving spirit who brought Türler's vision to life with a new concept and worked out its mathematical basis. The Swiss master watchmaker Jörg Spöring transformed figures and diagrams into a mechanical marvel of great precision, and the designer Bruno Hotz put a contemporary face on it. The heavens, the cosmos, the largest unity mankind is able to imagine. To break through the boundaries and to understand this concept, which encapsulates all matter, has always been mankind's aim. For thousands of years, we have tried to measure and predict the movement of the planets in our solar system. In the Türler clock, the largest unit is our solar system. We are watching from outside, observing the movement of the planets around the Sun in the planetarium, with the Sun in the center and the planets in their near circular orbit moving around it. This system was first suggested in ancient Greece, overturned by a geocentric theory for 15 centuries and newly established by Copernicus, Galileo, Kepler and Newton. Each planet revolves on its own specially dimensioned ring around the Sun. The reconstruction of the eccentric orbits of the planets does not need complicated lever mechanisms as in earlier clocks, but is done by an ingeniously simple gravitational device. The Türler clock differs basically from previous astronomical clocks. With the help of modern technology and Swiss watchmaker tradition, five movements emerged in which the mechanism itself becomes a readable logical system of the world. In the course of a year, we encounter our neighboring planets in ever-changing constellations. Faith in the influence of the stars on our future, rooted in the mechanics of our solar system. From ancient times, mankind has tried to represent the movement of the heavenly bodies visually. This astrarium, reconstructed according to the detailed plans of Giovanni Dondi in 1364, is one of the oldest examples of mechanical clock design for a complicated astronomical movement. As if in a journey through space, we are closing in on our home planet. The tellurion examines the mechanics of Earth, Sun, and the Earth's moon. The relationship of the two largest celestial phenomena determines the rhythm of our life. The axis of the Earth at an angle of 23.5 degrees to its orbit around the Sun and the elliptical orbit of the Moon around the Earth are realistically miniaturized in this movement.
Jetzt muss das auf gegenüber dem zweimal eine Umdrehung machen. Das ist, und jetzt hat es eine gemacht, jetzt ist es gegenüber. Mhm. Und jetzt der, wenn es wieder da ist, hat es die zwei gemacht.
San Michele, a small village in Lazio, Italy, close to the historical town of Orvieto, where in 1307 one of the first public clocks was erected. This is the retreat of Ludovico Oechslin, a scientist with wide-ranging knowledge. He studied archaeology, history and astronomy, holds a PhD in the history of technology, and is a master watchmaker. My intention with this elaborate mechanism was to design a lasting and true picture of the part of the cosmos near to us, the solar system in which we live. If the observer of this clock is keenly interested in studying the different movements and their interrelation, he may perceive the larger picture this astronomical work is projecting and, hopefully, initiate new personal ideas. If this clock leads to a mental process of the beholder, the object of our task has been achieved. Days, months, years. The all-embracing order of things on our planet. The sun as a force that creates and destroys life, the moon which influences the tides and our nocturnal musings and dreams. In the globe movement, the sun, the moon, and the stars rotate around the Earth. The armillary sphere as a reference grid and the ecliptic with the signs of the zodiac have been in use since ancient Greek astronomy. The globe is a complex system with six layers. Closest to the Earth's surface is the moon layer, with its axis at a slight angle to the sun. The sun moves around the Earth once in a year as a two-colored layer depicting the day and night zones. The sphere of the stars is the outermost layer of glass with the prominent constellations engraved. Further out is the ecliptic with the signs of the zodiac, a reference point for the other layers. Outermost is a metal grid with the equator, local meridian, and so on. The position of sun, moon, and stars can be read off directly from each point in the globe. Each movement was assembled by Jörg Spöring for a test run, taken to pieces, gold-plated as protection against oxidation of the brass parts, and then reassembled. The Türler clock is fully operational only when each wheel, each arbor, and each screw is fully functional and stays that way for many years to come. At night, the stars appear as fixed points, guides for our orientation in the sky. But the Earth, or on this globe, the firmament, rotates once in 25,794 years, the so-called Platonic year. And that is the time this cogwheel would need for one rotation. In the final step of our journey through space, we are standing on our planet. The horizon movement shows the motion of sun and moon from one spot. The horizon, etched in the front panel, reflects precisely the panorama from the roof of the Savoy Hotel in Zurich. In this way, the height and the angle of the sun and moon can be easily compared with the true horizon. The horizon is a unique and newly developed clock movement, mathematically designed by Ludovico Oechslin for this location. At noon, when the sun is at its zenith, the golden orb of the sun on the clock is also at its highest point in the day. Because Central European time is a compromise, the clock on St. Peter's Church marks the local time, 11:34. A similar horizon movement could be designed and built for every location on Earth. The calculations and the gear trains of Ludovico Oechslin were turned into computer-aided designs for manufacture. Here is an eccentric disk for the second anomaly of the moon. Each machined piece is finally smoothed and polished by hand by an experienced watchmaker. The moon's elliptic orbit at an angle around the Earth is mechanically extremely difficult to translate into the visual indicators on the horizon movement, as the moon seems to travel irregularly on its journey through the sky. Two of these anomalies with eccentric disks are used for the moon, another two for the sun. Every event in our near cosmos is directly readable on the Türler clock. For instance, the eclipse of the sun is on the horizon, an overlap of sun and moon. At the same time, the eclipse is visible on the globe and also on the tellurion. The moon moves between sun and earth. The Türler clock in Zurich is comparable to the most elaborate astronomical clocks ever made. The historian of horology, Gerhard Dom von Rossum.
Damals wie heute, das ist nicht die erste, historisch nicht die erste astronomische.
This is not the first astronomical clock. These mechanisms served, and are still serving today, to illustrate the relative motions and positions of planets, moons and stars with the aid of elaborate mechanical constructions. The attraction of these three-dimensional simulations, even for us today, is that very complicated equations can be reduced to visual simple movements. Or to exaggerate, even a child is able to understand the most intricate laws of the heavens with the help of these models. The fifth movement is dedicated to measured time. What might look like any clock has been newly designed in its gear trains. The leap years and all the normal calendar functions are up here. These are the two teeth for the 28th and 29th February. Here you see, if this tooth is engaged in the leap year gear, a second tooth of a gear, rotating once in 400 years, engages in this train. And every 400 years, or better, every 100th year, which can be divided by 4, the leap year is cancelled through this tooth. To help the observer, the designer Bruno Hotz made visible the logic behind this glory in gold. His framework of the clock is an elegant and functional compromise between transparency and stability. The rubies, used as bearings, sparkle in this marvel. Time itself turned into a work of art. Today is the longest day, the beginning of summer.